Hi and welcome by Jude. In this video I'll show you three methods to make a perfect wash. If you paint it with watercolor before, then you know it's very difficult to paint a perfect wash. But in this video we will practice a lot. So at the end of the video I hope you have the tools to make your own wash and practice that over and over again. Have fun watching this video. When you start with watercolor, you will notice that it can be quite hard to make a nice and even wash. But even when you paint a bit longer, it can be tricky. So it's good to practice this technique. I myself practice this once a week and use it very often as a warming up. There are some ways to make it more easy to paint a good wash. And in this video I will show you some tools and I hope they will help you as well. First, let's go through the materials we will need. You will need watercolor paper. You can use study paper, but I recommend to paint once in a while on cotton paper. You will see the difference. Cotton paper makes it more easy to make a good and even wash, because the paint spreads evenly around the paper. But it is expensive, so you can start on study paper. Make sure the paper is 300 grams, and for this exercise I use the cold pressed paper. It has some texture and I love this for painting landscapes and backgrounds. I'm working on a video about paper, so when this one is online I will put a link in the video where you can find it. You will also need a spray bottle with water, two jars with water, one for cleaning the brushes and one to use for mixing the paint. I will use a mop brush and I love this one because it holds a lot of water, or a flat brush will do. But you can use your own brushes. I don't recommend to use small brushes because the result can be stripy. Of course we will need some watercolor paint, pick a color you like. You will need some tape for dividing the paper into even pieces, and you can use it to tape the paper on a surface. You will tumble the paper, so don't tape it on your desk. You will need some kitchen paper or a cloth. And now you're good to go. We will start by a technique called wet in wet. So first I paint the surface with clean water. As you can see, my brush was a bit dirty, but that's no problem because it's the same color. Take some time for wetting the surface, so the paper is really damp. Make sure there are no puddles on the surface, because your paint will stay in the puddle and it will dry as a dark stain. Now we can mix the paint. Pick a color you like and spray on your paint to activate the pigments. You can use a spray bottle or a pipette. You have to make enough paint for the surface, because you don't want to mix the new paint during the painting. When the paint is ready and the paper damped, then you can start at the top of the paper with a brush loaded with paint. Work slowly from the top to the bottom. Because we are making an even wash and not a gradient, we pick up paint after every stroke, or at least every two strokes. Make a relaxed move with your brush and don't rub over the paper on the same place. Compare it to a meditation. you have to breathe in and out. So let the brush go from left all the way to the right and repeat this slowly. You will get a rhythm by practicing. No one can meditate like a pro in one session. That's the same with painting. You have to practice and make the technique your own. Try different techniques and you will find out what works best for you. When the first stroke is ready, you can lay the surface flat to dry. Okay, now we will paint the second wash. This technique is called wet on dry. That means you will paint with a wet or loaded brush on a dry surface. Make sure you have enough paint. Because you don't wet the paper, you will need a bit more slightly diluted version of the first wash to get the same result. Again, test the paint on a small piece of paper. And now we can do the same as we did in the first layer, but now you will notice that the paint don't spread so easily on the paper as it was in the first wash. But with a bit patience, you will get a feeling on how loaded your brush has to be. And again, be relaxed. And gently spread the paint from the left to the right and from the top to the bottom. It's up to you if you will tilt the paper, but I like to put a small item under my surface. When you practice a bit longer, you can try to make a drip or bead. Every time you work from the top to the bottom, you will lead the drip or the bead a bit lower. On this way, you will enhance the chance to make a perfect wash. And you can play with it. If you hold the paper vertical, the drip will fall. This can give a nice result. Here you see an example on how I played with multiple drips. Now you can finish this wash and I will see you at the next and last wash. Okay, get ready for the final wash. In this wash, we will use different techniques to make a perfect and even wash, even when we don't paint very neat. Again, make enough paint and make the consistency like the first wash, a bit creamy. Test on a small piece of paper and wet the surface with a clean brush with water. Make sure the water is spread right and let it sink in. This will cost a minute or so. It depends on how wet you paint, but we know that we can start when the shine is gone. Work all over the paper and add enough pigment. With this method you can paint a bit messy because it will become an even wash when you tumble the paper. So I think this is the most fun way to paint an even wash. Now spray the surface with water and tumble it from left to right and move the pigments over the paper. You can pick them up on the edges with a paper towel or a clean, slightly dry brush. Add some pigments if needed and have fun. You can lay the surface flat when you are happy with the result. Make sure the edges are clean so the water can't flow into your paper. Otherwise you will get cauliflower effect. Now you've painted even washes on three ways. Now it's time to be proud of yourself and pick a moment you will practice this again. Don't wait too long, so you won't forget how you did it. Do you want to get more examples or ways to paint washes or other techniques? Don't forget to subscribe and thumbs up if you liked the video. Have a nice and creative day, and I will see you next time. Bye, Jut.